The second book of Kings, chapter 13, verse 1 onwards. In the 23rd year of Joash, son of Ahaziah, king of Judah, Jehoahaz, son of Jehu, became king of Israel in Samaria. He reigned 17 years. He did evil in the eyes of the Lord by following the sins of Jeroboam, son of Nebat, which he had caused Israel to commit, and he did not turn away from them. So the Lord's anger burned against Israel, and for a long time he kept them under the power of Hazael, king of Aram, and Ben-Hadad his son. Then Jehoahaz sought the Lord's favor, and the Lord listened to him, for he saw how severely the king of Aram was oppressing Israel. The Lord provided a deliverer for Israel, and they escaped from the power of Aram. So the Israelites lived in their own homes as they had before. But they did not turn away from the sins of the house of Jeroboam, which he had caused Israel to commit. They continued in them. Also the Asherah pole remained standing in Samaria. Nothing had been left of the army of Jehoahaz, except 50 horsemen, 10 chariots, and 10,000 foot soldiers, for the king of Aram had destroyed the rest and made them like the dust of the threshing time. As for the other events of the reign of Jehoahaz, all he did and his achievements, are they not written in the book of the annals of the kings of Israel? Jehoahaz rested with his ancestors and was buried in Samaria. And Jehoash, his son, succeeded him as king. In the 37th year of Joash, king of Judah, Jehoash, son of Jehoahaz, became king in Israel in Samaria. He reigned 16 years. He did evil in the eyes of the Lord and did not turn away from any of the sins of Jeroboam, son of Nebat, which he had caused Israel to commit. He continued in them. As for the other events of the reign of Jehoash, and all he did, his achievements, including his war against Amaziah, king of Judah, are they not written in the book of the annals of the kings of Israel? Jehoash rested with his ancestors, and Jeroboam succeeded him on the throne. Jehoash was buried in Samaria with the kings of Israel. Now Elisha had been suffering from the illness from which he died. Jehoash, king of Israel, went down to see him and wept over him. My father," he cried, "the chariots and horsemen of Israel." Elisha said, "Get a bow and some arrows." And he did so. "Take the bow in your hands," he said to the king of Israel. When he had taken it, Elisha put his hands on the king's hands. "Open the east window," he said, and he opened it. "Shoot," Elisha said, and he shot. The Lord's arrow of victory, the arrow of victory over Aram, Elisha declared, "You will completely destroy the Arameans in Aphek." Then he said, take the arrows. And the king took them. Elisha told him, strike the ground. He struck it 3 times and stopped. The man of God was angry with him and said, you should have struck the ground 5 or 6 times. Then you would have defeated Aram and completely destroyed it. But now you will defeat it only 3 times. Elisha died and was buried. Now Moabite raiders used to enter the country every spring. Once, while some Israelites were burying a man, suddenly they saw a band of raiders. So they threw the man's body into Elisha's tomb. When the body touched Elisha's bones, the man came to life and stood up on his feet. Hazael, king of Aram, oppressed Israel throughout the reign of Jehoahaz. But the Lord was gracious to them and had compassion and showed concern for them because of his covenant with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. To this day, he has been unwilling to destroy them or banish them from his presence. Hazael, king of Aram, died, and Ben-Hadad, his son, succeeded him as king. Then Jehoash, son of Jehoahaz, captured from Ben-Hadad, son of Hazael, the towns he had taken in battle from his father Jehoahaz. 3 times Jehoash defeated him, and so he recovered the Israelite towns. Chapter 14. In the 2nd year of Jehoash, son of Jehoahaz, king of Israel, Amasya, son of Joash, king of Judah, began to reign. He was 25 years old when he became king, and he reigned in Jerusalem 29 years. His mother's name was Jehodan. She was from Jerusalem. He did what was right in the eyes of the Lord, but not as his father David had done. In everything, he followed the example of his father Joash. The high places, however, were not removed. The people continued to offer sacrifices and burn incense there. After the kingdom was firmly in his grasp, he executed the officials who had murdered his father, the king. Yet he did not put the children of the assassins to death. With accordance with what is written in the book of the law of Moses, where the Lord commanded, parents are not to be put to death for their children, or children put to death for their parents. Each will die for their own sin. He was the one who defeated 10,000 Edomites in the Valley of Salt and captured Sela in battle, calling it Joktil, the name it has to this day. Then Amasya sent messengers to Jehoash, son of Jehoahaz, the son of Jehu, king of Israel, with the challenge, come, let us face each other in battle. But Jehoash, king of Israel, replied to Amasya, king of Judah, a thistle in Lebanon sent message to a cedar in Lebanon. Give your daughter to my son in marriage. Then a wild beast in Lebanon came along and trampled the thistle underfoot. You have indeed defeated Edom, and now you are arrogant. Glory in your victory, but stay at home. Why ask for trouble and cause your own downfall, that of Judah also? This is the holy word of the Lord.